In this tutorial, I will show you step by step how to configure iTheme Security, the free version. I will show you how to secure the most abused login ways on your WordPress website, how to secure your backend so that nobody can brute force attack you, how to enable or disable all those emails coming from iThemes, and of course, I will walk you through all the options within iThemes. Now, I have created this tutorial as part of my WordPress Security The Circle of Five, because this plugin, iThemes, is only one of the five security measures that you should take securing your website. Your security is just as strong as the weakest link, so definitely watch that video before you go and install iThemes, because it will give you the context and it will help you securing every part of your WordPress website. And I want you to be safe, because I once got hacked years ago in my early years. I've been building WordPress websites since 2004, and once upon a time I woke up, I look at my website, and gang, this is what I saw. Did it look great? No. Did I hate it? Yes. Did I fix it? Of course. But prevention is always better than to fix it. Well, as I have my own national hosting company and my web development agency, I am responsible of quite a little lot of traffic on the internet for my website's clients. So yes, it should be secure. Are these websites being attacked? Yes, sir. Every single day we get automated attacks from different countries all around the world. So follow me and I will guide you through this process of installing and securing your WordPress website with iThemes. Let's go. Log into your WordPress dashboard. It will be the last time that you will be using WP Admin, so enjoy. So you go to Plugins, Add New, and we search for plugins iThemes Security. You press install now, and we press activate. When the plugin is activated, we go on the left side, we press security, and we go to settings. And immediately we're starting with the security check. Press enable security check pro and press secure site. So fill in your email address right here and press activate network brute force protection and redirect HTTP request to HTTPS. Well done, your site has been secured in the basics. All right, let's press close and let's start with all the settings that we need to change. The security check, we just did it, so we can go to the global settings. Press configure settings. In here you will find the global settings. You can change here the messages that people will see when they try to log into. You have been locked out due to too many infinite login attempts. You really didn't think we were that stupid, did you? Your IP address has been flagged as a threat by the iThemes network. You really didn't think we were that stupid, did you? All right, here you can change the how many times someone will be banned after they try to log into your WordPress website. It's standard on 3 logouts. We can keep it that way and they remain it for 7 days. And if you try to log in within 15 minutes 3 times, then you will be locked out. Let's change it to 20 minutes. And if you don't use a VPN, you can press this button and it will add your current IP to the authorized host list. This means that you will never be locked out from your own website. It is very important to do that. However, if you are like me, you have a VPN, and this IP address will change every time I restart my PC. So I'm gonna remove this because it will not make any sense. Alright, this is all about the log files. Log files are very handy if you want to see what went wrong sometimes. And we press save settings. Alright, let's go to the notification center. This is very important because you don't want to receive an email every single day. So if you just scroll down, you can now change the security digest. I would recommend this to turn this off and turn this off, because you really don't want to receive every single day an email from iThemes that something happened in regarding to your security. Of course, if you want to receive those mails and if you're very interested, just leave them on and press save settings.
Here you can change the user groups per user what they must do. Well, you have to turn this off for all users. Manage item security, you're the only one that should really do this. We do require strong passwords so that everybody needs to have the strong ones. Press save and press close. Alright, here is a 404 detection automatically blocks users snooping around for pages to exploit. My advice is to enable this one. Press configure settings. And let's put them on 5 minutes and hit 20 errors. When they hit 20 errors, they will be blocked out from your website. These files are on the ignore list, very important. And these file types will be ignored because they can't do anything with these files. Press save settings. This is the away mode. If you enable this one and we go to configure settings, in this way, you can just block out your WordPress dashboard in a certain time frame. So let's restrict it from 1 a.m. to 6 a.m. in the night, because this is my time zone and I never work between 1 and 6. Press save settings and you won't be able to access your WordPress website between those times. Remember, this is a powerful feature. You will never be able to enter your WordPress website between these times. So think about it, remember it, you cannot update your website by these times. And make sure your time zone settings are is okay, because when this time is not correct, you have a problem because you will be locked out when you're trying to change your website. So keep that in mind, be careful with this setting. Alright, if you're happy with it, press save settings. And we go to the banned users. Here you can enable the hackrepairs.com ban list. This is a very good list, just enable this one. And if you want to ban a host individual, you got an IP number, you can add them here. I'm sure you don't have any bad IPs, but if you do, just add them here. Press save settings. And let's go to the database backup. If you don't have a database backup in place, or your host does not create daily backups, you can create these daily backups and they will email them to you. You press enable schedules database backups and you can backup the interval for, let's say, 1 day or 3 days or 13 days or whatever you would like to do. Well, we are using our host to do all the backups and it's a very solid system, so we don't enable any settings, we just press save settings. Alright, let's enable the file change detection on this website. With this module enabled, iThemes will constantly check your website if there have been changes on your website. You can scan the files right now and then they can see if there are changes happening on your website. So there are some folders that you need to exclude from this list, or you will get emails every single day from changed files. Just go ahead and when you see those emails, you can ignore and exclude those files from this module. I'm talking about the TMP file, we can exclude it. We can also exclude, for example, the all-in-one backups. We can also exclude WC logs, because those things will change very often. WordPress contact form 7 uploads. We need to exclude those from the scan, or you will get every single day an email that those files has been changed. All right, press save settings. And we go to file permissions, the load files permissions details. And on the file permissions, you will see that the suggested value must be 755. This is for security reasons. If you see files like this and you see this warning, you should change these to 755 because 444 is not very safe. Press close. And we go to the local brute force protection. Here you can change the max login attempts and per user and the minutes how to remember them. So let's make that 3 attempts and let's let anyone try for 5 times and we have to remember it for 10 minutes. Alright, the admin user. You should never have an admin user on your WordPress website because it's the most used user on the world. So immediately ban a host that attempts to log in using the admin username. This is a powerful feature, but remember, if you try to log in this way, you will be blocked out your own website immediately, unless you have whitelisted your IP address in the previous module. So press save settings and we go to password requirements. Strong passwords are enabled. Which one? All of them should use strong passwords. Press save settings and we go to SSL. We have enabled this one, so this is okay. Press save settings. There we go to the system tweaks. Press enable and press configure settings. All right, we need to protect the system files. It's very important, so no one can access these files. We should disable directory browsing. Yes. Filter request methods. Yes, we should filter that one. If you see that your WooCommerce web shop or anything is dysfunctioning, you can turn this off and see if that fixes your problems. Suspicious query strings, we should really filter them out because they will add a lot of characters and a lot of strings into your URL to see if something happens. Filter non-English characters. If you have a website that is English or another language, just press this one, filter them non-English characters so they will be removed automatically. We don't want that, so you can safely turn this on. If you see any problems with your web shop, turn this off to see if that fixes it all. The file writing permissions, yes, we should remove those. And you want to disable the PHP uploads. We want to disable them in plugins. And we want to disable them in themes. Press save settings. And we go to the WordPress salt. It's a secret key that makes your site harder to hack and access by adding random elements to your password. Right, we just change them and press save settings. Alright, so you have logged out and now we have logged in again and we changed the last one, the WordPress tweaks. Alright, the WordPress tweaks are very important. We should remove the Windows Live Writer header unless you use Windows Live Writer or other blogging clients that rely on this file. You should disable this one, but let's enable it. We should remove the RSD header because we don't need it on this website. If you do integrate services like Flickr, then disable this one. Reduce your comment spam, of course. Disable the file editor. It is this thing in appearance. Here is a file editor. If it's enabled, then anyone who can log into your WordPress dashboard can change these things. The XML RPC feature, I've thought about just one in the WordPress Security Circle of 5, and you should really disable this one. Just so you know, if you use other third-party software that hooks into your WordPress website, you should enable it. Multiple authentication attempts, we should really block it because this is the most used feature to hack a WordPress website. Restrict access to your REST API, of course. We should disable your login error messages so nobody sees what happens when they try to log in and they get an error message. Unique nicknames are very important. Let's force them to do that and disable the user's author pages. We should protect our website against tab snapping and we should log in with email address and username. That is okay. If you want to change it, you can use it to email address only or username only. If you want to change it, I suggest you use email address if you have a non-guessable email address. But let's leave it for the same on this website. All right, let's press save settings. And now we go to the advanced options. We have the admin user. Right, if you have a admin username, then you can change it right here to another one. But this change made by this tool could cause compatibility issues with some plugins or themes. So make sure to make a backup before you do this. Easiest way to do it is just to remove your admin user and create a new one. Change your content directory. This is something that you should not do on a live website. I've done it a couple of times and it broke my website instantly because your content directory is most important to your WordPress website. So never ever do this on a live website. change the database prefix. It's also a very powerful tool, and our database is using the default table prefix WP underscore. This is really a security issue, and we should definitely change this. We press yes, and everything will be changed before our eyes. Press save changes. And now we go to the hide backend feature. We should really enable this one, and you can add here another URL that you want to use to log into your WordPress website. You should make this unique. So I, for example, would do WordPress login Max Austria. If they try to log in with WP admin, they will be redirected to a custom location. So let's make the custom location gotcha hacker. And now they will be redirected to that website. Press save settings. And now we have to log into our website using this URL. Now you better save this URL somewhere safe, because if you forget it, you will never be able to log in again in your WordPress website. So let's see what happens when we go to maxaustria.com/wp-admin. And we will go to the page gotcha hacker. Max Austria, follow the advice from the WordPress doctor to stay safe. So that works. Alright, here are server config rules. If you don't know what this is, please leave this page by pressing the cross. So now your website has been thoroughly set up and secured by iTeam Security Pro. If you press on this little button up here, you will see a little bit of messages when iTeams want to warn you about something. You can dismiss them pressing the cross, and you can review the logs if you see anything interesting to look at.
Alright, very good. You have secured your WordPress installation with iThemes. I'm proud of you. Now, that wasn't so hard, was it? So if I helped you out in this video, hit that like button so I know we are on the right track. It's only one of the five you just did, so make sure you watch my video about the Circle of Five. If you haven't watched it yet, you can click it right here. If you have already watched it, then you should definitely watch my other video about WordPress SEO, because your website deserves to be found, and I'm gonna help you with it as good as I can. Have an awesome day.